Fruit fly can have a devastating impact of up to $1.3 billion on local horticultural industries. You may have seen some guys in orange overalls walking around local streets lately. They're working with PIRSA on the cleanup, and I'm here with Nick from PIRSA to tell us a little bit about what's going on.
Thanks, Ed. Yeah, we're really busy at the moment, and there's some really important things that people at home can do to help us with our efforts. During a fruit fly response, you'll see our teams in orange overalls out there doing work in the field. One of the really important jobs that the teams do every week is to go out and apply an organic fruit fly bait to people's backyards. It's a really, really safe bait to use. It's an organic compound that only affects fruit flies. And it's really important we get that out there regularly because it attracts fruit flies to the bait. The fruit flies eat the bait and it kills them. The other important job that our guys do is to pick up any fallen fruit. If you can imagine, a fruit fly needs fruit to complete its life cycle. So if we can pick up fruit off the ground and make sure it doesn't complete its life cycle, we can break that cycle and eradicate the pest. So there's a number of things that you can do to help control fruit fly. One really important step is to check your fruit. If you see anything that's wriggling around that looks like maggots, please call our hotline. It's 1300 666 010, and we'll come out and make sure it's not fruit fly. If you're in an outbreak area, please don't compost your fruit. What you need to do is pick that fruit up and put it in your council green waste bin, and we can dispose of it properly and break that life cycle. Please don't share your backyard fruit with your family or your friends. By all means, use it yourself. You can stew it, you can cook it, you can freeze it, but please don't move it around, don't share it, and that way we can break the life cycle of the pest. Another really important thing you can do is make sure we can access your backyard to control the fruit fly. We have to be able to get into people's backyards to apply our organic bait and also pick up any fallen fruit. There's nothing to worry about there. We're working with you to make sure we eradicate this pest quickly. So if you see someone in their orange overalls knock on your front door, please let them have access to the backyard and we'll be able to do the job and move on reasonably quickly. Fruit fly can be a really devastating pest if it gets established. It affects a range of fruits, from citrus to stone fruit to tomatoes to chilies to apples. All those soft fruits that people love to grow in their backyard can be affected by fruit fly. And if fruit fly gets into your fruit, it fills them up with maggots, so no one wants to eat them. If fruit fly isn't controlled, it affects produce, and that means we can't eat it and we can't sell that produce because no one wants to buy produce that's got maggots in it. Right now, South Australia is the only mainland state that's fruit fly free. So our growers can grow clean produce and sell it to people who can buy it without any chemicals and know they're not going to bite into maggots. Please check the PIRSA website for the latest details showing maps of where the fruit fly outbreak area is. If you're in an outbreak area, please don't move fruit because that's the only way that fruit fly can be moved around. We take zero chances with fruit fly. Our growers depend on you to keep South Australia fruit fly free.